first name that is difficult to say. It was given me the day I was born. Want to know about the stories of the empire of old? My eyes say more of me than what you dare to say. All I know of you is all the sides of war. A film by Coppola, the helicopters roar. One day I'll touch your soul. One day I'll finally know your soul. One day I'll come to you to say hello.
When talking about Vietnam, people often think about the image of a woman in a white form traditional costume, Áo Dài, seen appearing for the first time in 1744. Áo Dài has constantly changed depending on its historical period. Now, it has become a symbol of the traditional cultural beauty of Vietnamese women. In terms of the structure of an Áo Dài, it was carefully designed with two long pieces of shirt prolonged from neck to toe and a round along neck collar to create a discreet look. Sleeves of Áo Dài had no shoulders and extend from the collar to the wrist. This shirt is often worn with elegant white leg pants. Áo Dài can be sewn from many different fabrics. Four of them have a common characteristic of soft, light, and airy, so it can be suitable for figures and highlight the tender beauty of Asian women when wearing. That's why Vietnamese women are likely to wear Áo Dài on special occasions, such as wedding ceremonies, anniversaries, Lunar New Year, especially the national festival taking place in the ancient capital. To complete the beauty of Áo Dài, people often combine it with Nón Lá, another traditional symbol of Vietnam. At first, Nón Lá was created and used mainly by farmers to save from the sun and rain, but later, it became more popular with all Vietnamese, particularly those who live in the countryside. The Nón Lá is special because it is 100% handmade and has to go through many first steps to produce an eye-catching product. Through Nón Lá, people can see not only the meticulousness of Vietnamese, but also the cultural beauty of an agricultural country like Vietnam.
Huế Royal Refined Music or Nhã Nhạc Cung Đình Huế means elegant music of the Huế royalty in Vietnamese. In royal events, these performing arts usually appear at the opening and closing ceremonies. Its orchestra includes musicians wearing Áo Dài and turban who play traditional instruments. In terms of the history, Huế Royal Refined Music first appeared in the Lý Dynasty in 1010. However, it became a symbolic form of music in Vietnamese royalty under the Nguyễn Dynasty in 1802. Impressively, in 2003, Huế Royal Refined Music was recognized by UNESCO as a masterpiece of oral and intangible heritage. And now, it has been introduced to the world and has a strong reputation for its uniqueness. Long time ago, Huế Royal Refined Music was performed in the Imperial City of Huế. But today, whenever the Huế Festival is held, this place becomes an idealistic venue for the performers. Another place where you can contemplate this orchestra is the stylized dragon boat in the Hương River. To create such a masterpiece, traditional instruments commonly used for performance include kèn bầu, conio a bow, đàn tỳ bà, a pear-shaped lute with four strings, đàn nguyệt, moon-shaped, two-string lutes, đàn tam, fretless lutes with snakeskin covered body and three strings, đàn nhị, two-string vertical fiddle, sáo, a bamboo transverse flute, trống, drum, and other percussion instruments. Distinctive as it is, Huế Roy refined music is a form of art that you will not find anywhere else, although it might seem outdated and unattractive compared to trendy songs on music charts. But once you sense the serene ambience of Huế City, you will feel the music's power even without understanding a single word. With amazing vestiges of the feudal time, Huế is a must-visit city in Vietnam. Once coming here, don't miss the chance to enjoy the signature performing arts called Huế Royal
Vietnamese sandwich or banh mi is a loaf of toast with a crispy crust and soft airy texture inside. We usually split banh mi lengthwise and fill it with savory ingredients. Depending on regional culture or personal preference, people can choose from many different fillings. However, the traditional type of filling usually contains sausages, meat, eggs, along with some other ingredients such as pate, butter, vegetables, chili sauce, and pickles. Banh mi is considered a popular fast food and is usually consumed for breakfast or any meal of the day. Because of its reasonable price, banh mi has become a favorite dish of many people. Regarding the history of banh mi, although considered one of the best street food in Vietnam, banh mi has its origin in a distant European country. Although quite a few people do not admit this, to be fair, banh mi was not originally from Vietnam. In 1859, the baguette, made from wheat flour of the West, followed the French army on their way to invade Gia Đình Citadel. Banh mi back then was still very Western style, dense and not as crispy as it is now. It wasn't until the government decided to provide a standard diet consisting of bread and milk to primary schools that Vietnamese bread had the first change from the original recipe. Through the process of learning, combined with the ingredients available in the country, the first batch of An Nam bread was officially released. It is also from here that the big tree of Vietnamese cuisine. Banh mi is a symbolic dish for Vietnamese street food. You can find it everywhere, from street vendors to large restaurants. There is a fact I want to tell you that banh mi, the so-called simple food, has beaten the big brands in the fast food market. From McDonald's to Burger King all did not achieve great success when deciding to expand into the Vietnamese market. Anyway, if you have any chance, let's come to Vietnam to enjoy banh mi. I'm sure that Vietnamese people will be very glad and hospitable to welcome you.
No one knows exactly how or when coffee was discovered. We just know it is one of the most attractive, privileged, and delicious drinks in the world. Without a doubt, coffee in Vietnam is an integral part of Vietnamese cultures and the Vietnamese economy. Vietnam is growing as the second coffee exporter in the world. Vietnam's main coffee export market include Europe, the US, Russia, Japan, and the UK. In the EU market, Vietnam is the second largest coffee supplier after Brazil. Vietnamese coffee is famous for its iced coffee origin in the south, iced coffee in the north, and trifuller coffee. In terms of history, coffee was first introduced to Vietnam in 1855 by a French colonist. initially planted on a small farm, this quickly changed into large-scale productions on massive plantations located in the highlands of Vietnam. But what really propelled Vietnam onto the world stage of coffee were Đổi Mới economic reforms of 1987, which greatly opened the country for trade. Types of coffee in Vietnam. Most of the coffee in Vietnam is made by a three filters. As a result, the coffee served is very dense with its strong flavors and high caffeine nations. The first one is black Vietnamese coffee. Black coffee is served hot or cold and is often served with sugars to balance the bitter flavor. This coffee is very potent and is served in a small cup. Black Vietnamese coffee is for those who want the strongest coffee available. Second one is Ai Vietnamese coffee with condensed milk. This popular drink is served throughout the countries in variety of styles. The most popular in the north is called Cafe Sirfin, which is served in a small brewing tin over a glass and requires you to mix the coffee with condensed milk and pour over ice. The third one is coffee with eggs. This unique coffee with sugars, condensed milk and the yolk of a chicken egg. This blend is typically served in Hanoi and has been a popular coffee choice since the mid-19s, reportedly created due to the scarcity of milk at that time. Cafes in Vietnam are abundant on every street corner, from a sidewalk vendors to a spacious garden cafes. There is never a shortage of choice for coffee. So don't worry if you are a coffee lover and you are one to come to Vietnam.